Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I declare the sixth sitting of the 23rd session of the Conference of State Parties open. First of all, I'd like to inform you the recent developments, the work I have done up to now. Since we adjourned after the previous sitting, I have carried out extensive consultations with a number of delegations in order to find a possible compromise for the successful completion of the work of our session. I have received the comments of the draft report as issued earlier on the symbol C-22/CRP.2, as well as proposals for additional languages to be included in the final report of the 23rd session. Based on further consultations, I was able to take those proposals on board and prepare the revised version of draft report. In my work, I was striving to arrive not only a compromise solution, but to produce a document that can be adopted by consensus. I'm very grateful to all the delegation that contributed to the revised draft report. Yesterday, I submitted the revised version of the draft report to the General Committee at the meeting we held at 2:45 p.m. At this point in time, I'm pleased to report to the plenary that the General Committee considered the revised draft report in a very positive manner. I'm truly heartened by the constructive attitude and the support I received from the General Committee in our common endeavors to revive the spirit of compromise and consensus in our work. The General Committee and I, as its chairperson, consider that the revised version of the draft report represents a compromise document. So the General Committee recommends unanimously that the revised draft report we have before us be the adopted basis on consensus. On this understanding, a proposal was made at the General Committee meeting to remove square brackets from the text of revised draft report and to submit a clean version to the plenary for adoption. Subsequently, the revised version of the draft report was issued yesterday under the symbol C-23/CIP.2/LEP1, dated 28 November 2018. Your Excellencies, distinguished delegates, let me be very open. I look at the fact the revised draft report has been submitted to the plenary without square brackets, not as procedural precedent, but rather as a sign and fact of vivid manifestation of the common desire to revive and reinstate of the spirit of consensus, which so many delegations referred to in their statements during the general debate. Before we proceed the adoption of the report, I'd like to inform you, the plenary, that I was approached by one delegation with the request to make a change to existing para 1.2 of the draft report, replacing the word delegations in the first sentence by states parties. If there is no objection, there will be a done by the technical secretariat when issuing the final report. In this spirit, may I ask if you now agree to adopt the revised draft report as we have it in front of us as a whole, without going through it paragraph by paragraph? Yeah. Iran delegation, you have a floor.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I would like to thank and appreciate your hard efforts, and we believe that you have reached a very good result, and my delegation is ready to join consensus on this report. However, as usual, we have a reservation on a specific paragraph 1.3, which I would like to put it for the record of the conference. And we will ask this reservation will be circulated as an official document of this conference. On behalf of the delegation of the Islamic Republic of Iran, I would like to pronounce my country's principal position on the Zionist regime of Israel. The Islamic Republic of Iran does not recognize the Zionist regime of Israel, and its attendance in this conference of state party does not constitute its recognition by my delegation. I thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Iranian delegation. May I suggest the Iranian delegation that your statement will be, you want to, that your statement will reflect in the draft decision or draft report, or you want to issue the separate statement, will be taken back care of by the technical secretariat. Yeah, Iran, you have a floor.
Mr. Chairman, we are flexible. We can go along with the current text. We will send it to the secretariat to be posted as an official document of the conference. Thank you.
Thank you for your consideration. And then any other comment for the adoption of the draft final report? There's no objection? So, yes, I see the Cote d'Ivoire. You have a floor. Direction of Cote d'Ivoire.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Monsieur le Président, Mr. Chairman, pas sur le fond du document,
I'm taking the floor not to speak to the substance of the report.
Observation de forme,
I just have an editorial observation, but it does have its importance.
Qui concerne le point,
it relates to paragraph
20.5, c'est-à-dire la commission de vérification des pouvoirs.
The Credentials Committee.
Monsieur le Président, étant donné que ce rapport constitue le rapport final
que la conférence va adopter,
je constate qu'il est dit à ce point que mon pays, la Côte d'Ivoire, a présenté une copie de l'aide
des pouvoirs,
alors que nous avons bel et bien déposé les pouvoirs originaux.
Where in fact we deposited the original credentials and not a copy. So, Mr. Chairman, I would like that to be duly reflected in our final report. So please introduce this correction before the final adoption of our report.
Nevertheless, may
we would like this to be reflected in the report that Cote d'Ivoire did deposit the originals of its credentials. Thank you.
Thank you, Ambassador, and considering your comment, and then the draft report will be updated. I see no objection. It's so adopted. Thank you so much. I'm so pleased and honored. See the adoption of the final report by consensus. I'm extremely happy that all the delegation go home with something, not empty-handed. I'd like to throw the open any final comment, any final statement from the distinguished delegates. Nobody wishes to take the floor. Thank you for cooperation and support and patience. Let me make a final closing remark. Distinguished Director General and His Excellencies, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, 23rd session of the Conference of State Parties has reached its end. I wish to thank all the delegation for their support to me in my role as a conference chairperson, their active participation in our discussions, and their hard work in helping bring this session of the conference to a successful conclusion. Our time has been intensive, but I wish to stress that the outcome has been a positive one, as we are able to consider and adopt a number of important decisions. I look forward to the continue our fruitful cooperation in this newly revived spirit of cooperation and consensus of the incoming year. We, the state parties to the convention, share the common goal of the ridding the world of chemical weapons. This organization gives us the opportunity to share the whole range of views on issues of common interest. I can only encourage you to keep looking beyond our differences. We must focus on constructive dialogue and continued cooperation in the coming year ahead. I'd like to take this opportunity to express my sincere gratitude to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the Netherlands and the Municipality of The Hague for being such a gracious host. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank the Director General and all the Secretary of State for assisting me and the conference in their performance of our duties. My sincere gratitude also goes to the Vice Chairs, members of the General Committee, and the Credentials Committee. Finally, I wish to appreciate the tireless work of the interpreters and translators and the editors and the conference room clerks and the people at the Documentation Center and the technicians and all staff members who assist us. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished delegates, I now declare the 23rd session of the Conference of the State Parties closed. Thank you very much.
Yeah.